Hey everybody, what's going on? I am Gregg Sussman, joined today by Tom Vecchio of FanDuel, who's here to give out his top value plays for Week 9 in DFS. What's going on, Tom?
I'm doing good. You know, there's not too many injuries on this slate, so it makes finding values a little bit interesting, but I'm ready to hop in.
So let's begin with the Las Vegas Raiders and specifically Henry Ruggs. Ruggs is priced at $5,700 here this week on FanDuel, and Ruggs has been an inconsistent player. I mean, a lot of rookies are, but we knew him from college as being the deep shot guy, and Mike Mayock said, listen, we're going to use him all over the field. It hasn't happened. I know it doesn't need to happen. You just need just a couple of big plays to make it work. Why would you get the big plays that you need this weekend out of Henry Ruggs?
Yeah, I think everything you said, to start is true, right? He's inconsistent, but we want those big plays, right? We're searching for that home run ball from Ruggs. And, you know, a couple of days ago, I spoke about Herbert. I love this game environment, 53.5 over under. You know, I hope it hits the over. We're looking at plenty of options here. But Ruggs, sitting at $5,700, doesn't necessarily have to do a whole lot to pay off his salary. If we look back 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, whenever it was when they played the Kansas City Chiefs, we saw that Ruggs only had three targets, but he brought two of them in for 118 yards. And a touchdown, and we see him get close to 20 FanDuel points. That is the home run shot we want to be taking a look at, right? He has an A dot sitting at 17.8 this season, getting downfield. And considering we're expecting a bit of a shootout because the Raiders' defense is just so weak, that deep ball they're going to need to get back in this game. So I like the price tag on him. I like the fact that we're looking at like a mini DeSean Jackson where we just need a few big plays from him. We don't need to rely on a ton of catches.
This is not a guy that's going to go 10 for 130 or anything like that, but that 2 for 118 sounds all right with a touchdown, and that's what we're looking at with a Charger secondary that's certainly beatable, and I believe Henry Ruggs has the speed to do just that. Derek Carr's going to take his shots. If he can connect, we're going to get a big game out of Henry Ruggs priced under $6,000 this week. Last week, there was so much uncertainty going on the Seattle backfield. Who is going to start? Well, it turned out there was no Chris Carson. There was no Carlos Hyde. It was all about DJ Dallas. And this week, it's kind of more of the same. It's all been quiet on the Seahawks front. And now I think that uncertainty is not so uncertain because of how DJ Dallas performed last week. $5,100 is the price, still really low for Dallas. And if once again he's the man, well, this seems like a no-brainer.
Absolutely a no-brainer. You know, I picked him up in my season-long league just because I needed someone to start at running back and got a really solid performance out of him. He played on 79% of the snaps last week. He saw the ball 23 total times. He had two total touchdowns for a total of 20.3 FanDuel points. And this is the kind of situation where we kind of have to wait and see where Chris Carson is not going to be practicing all week. They said he will test his foot on Friday, and that's where we're going to get more clarity. We know that Hyde is out. Travis Homer was healthy for last week's game, but we saw DJ Dallas really, really take control of the backfield while Carson was out. So if he is out again, Carson that is, we're going to be looking back to DJ Dallas at $5,100.
Travis Homer, the only one of the top three running backs for Seattle that was active, as you said, but he took a back seat to DJ Dallas. It'll be more of the same here this Sunday at $5,100 for the running back on Russell Wilson's Seahawks. Well, it's obviously a no-brainer. Love this pick here on FanDuel this Sunday. One more pick to give you, and this is a sneaky one. It's Marvin Hall of the Lions, priced at $4,600, and there's a lot of confusion on what's going on in Detroit. We know Kenny Galladay is not going to play. Matthew Stafford is on the COVID list at the moment. We'll see if he plays. Marvin Jones has gotten all the attention on the waiver wire, but Marvin Hall is certainly a part of this offense. Why do you believe that Hall is worth the dart throw here at $4,600?
Yeah, there's a lot going on for the Lions this week. We know that, as you said, Kenny Galladay is out. We know that Stafford is out right now, but he still has the potential to play. And really, I think Hall at $4,600, which is just such a great salary to drop into some of your lineups, really can pay that off pretty quickly. Now, I went back last week, or I looked back at the game log from last week, and Kenny Galladay only played 18 snaps. Hall then comes in, plays 42 snaps, and saw seven targets. All seven of those targets came in the second half when Galladay didn't play. Now they're going up against the Vikings this week, who are allowing 39.1 FanDuel points per game to opposing wide receivers. That is the second most in the league behind Seattle. So a super, super cheap price tag on Hall this week. We have a spot where he should be seeing plenty of snaps, and we have a really weak defense. So I like the spot. I'll love it even more if Stafford's starting, but at $4,600, he's a great value play.
doesn't cost you nearly anything at under 5K. And Marvin Hall, just watching that game on Sunday, he was a major part of the offense in the second half. And now the game plan may change, and a lot's going to depend on if Matthew Stafford is available. But TJ Hawkinson, someone you're going to look at, Marvin Jones, and then Marvin Hall, the sneaky play, under 5K on FanDuel this weekend. That's going to do it for us here on the FanDuel Hurry Up. Tom, we appreciate the time. Good luck this weekend.
Same to you. Talk to you next week.
Absolutely. Tomorrow, we wrap up our Week 9 preview coverage. Jim Sonnis will join me as we take a look at the top stacks on the board here this weekend. For Tom Vecchio, I'm Gregg Sussman. Thanks so much for watching. Enjoy Thursday Night Football, and I'll see you back here tomorrow for another edition of the FanDuel Hurry Up.